Cuba. It's a country never seen by most Americans. Even though relations between the United States and Cuba seem to be improving, Cuban citizens are still seeking democracy. We have a Cuban refugee right here in Mobile, and our Allison Spann sat down with him to talk Cuba, communism, and his quest for freedom.
Cuba, the only communist country the United States has ever barred its citizens from visiting. It's been under dictatorship for as long as Luis Castellanos can remember. 6 months ago, Luis came to Mobile seeking political asylum, and we used a translator to tell his story.
Before I left Cuba, it was very complicated. Because in my latter days in Cuba, I was involved in an opposition campaign against the regime.
In Cuba, going against the Castro regime brings grave consequences.
Fear is always something that you feel whenever you're opposing the dictator in Cuba. I didn't only feel fear for myself, but I also felt fear for my family. So when I oppose, when anyone is part of an opposition movement, they feel fear for not only themselves, but for their family as well.
Life in a communist country is a life without the simple freedoms we enjoy here in the United States every single day.
We don't have freedom to establish meetings and groups. We don't have the ability to choose a democratic government the way we want to.
But he says the possibility of American trade and travel could be a step towards change for the country.
Yes, it's a great opportunity for change. Because of the new relation of trade and travel, it has a great chance of bettering the situation.
Luis left behind a law career, his wife and two little girls who he misses very much. But his move here, he says, is about their future.
Yeah, that's exactly what I want for my children. I don't want my children to suffer the same consequences that I suffered. I fear for their future.
Luis is proud to be in America, and he says he's working hard to learn English so that one day he can enjoy all that this country has to offer. In Mobile, Allison Spann, News 5.
Luis hopes his wife and two daughters will be able to join him here in the United States as soon as he becomes established.